Hello guys, welcome to another tutorial. I know it's been a while, lots have happened, I've been working a lot, and I was also like in a small, well not small, I was in an accident. I was in the hospital for like 4 days. I recuperated, then it was my birthday last weekend, and there's just been a lot going on. Yeah, but I'll show you guys the details. Probably I'll tell you guys in another video. I know it's been a while, and I'll just get started with this. So today we're gonna be creating the shader for the Pokeball, the luxury Pokeball. So it has like the gold medal and then gold ribbons on the side, and the bottom it doesn't, which is great. Just in the top. Awesome. I thought that at the bottom it had it in my test. I don't know why I did it with. Did I do it with the bottom? No, I guess not. So yeah. So it gets a little bit complicated, especially around these edges right here, but we'll get started. Okay. So first of all, let's take the Pokeball that we have created and let's go into shading. Let's join right clicking here and let's join these two segments right here. Okay, and let's turn this into the viewport. Press Z, go into material preview, zoom in, rotate. Sorry about that. That way we can kind of see in the corner how is it going. All right, so if you have your Node Wrangler on, and we cover that in another episode, go into your add-ons and activate that Node Wrangler on. So Control T and G to move this. Actually, go back. We need to make sure that we're on the top first. Okay. Now, Control T. All right, let's eliminate this. And then switch from UV to object. All right, we won't be needing this anymore, so we can put it there. All right, this one, the C axis needs to be 0. Excellent. So we have this nice color here. All right, afterwards we need to divide that position. So we're gonna do Shift A, convert, separate X, Y, and Z. And then, yeah, so as you can see, it's being divided. And then we need to combine them again. All right, so let's combine them. Okay, I guess that didn't work. Combine, okay, cool. And let's combine it with the Y as well. Awesome, so we kind of did similar to what we had, but it's not taking the Z into account. Move this over here. This one, I don't need to see it anymore. We see what is happening. Actually, let's leave them open for now. Okay. Excellent. Then what we need is a texture, gradient texture, selected to be quadrant. Sphere. Okay. Then after that, we need a ramp so we can get a clear cut on the circle. Change it to constant. Okay. Move the white to 0.082. I know, very specific. Then make another black. And then move the black to 0.257. Excellent. And we already have like this band. Now we need another band in the here and here. Okay. So duplicate this. Shift D. And let's attach it here for now. Okay, so this is what it's looking. All right, and we need to shift these colors around. Okay, now we have the black in the middle. And for the black, we need to do 0.091. And then for the white, we need to do 0.22. Okay, awesome. After that, just so we can have more controls later on, let's duplicate this, Shift D, let's move it here, take one of these ones out, move it to the middle, 0.5, and for the white, we're gonna change the color to FFB100. Okay, awesome. All right, so then let's do a mixture, Shift D. Mix RGB, and then Shift A, color, invert. Okay, and let's plug this here and here. Actually, here. Okay, awesome. As you can see, now we are only taking this part into account, and we have this metal with this color. And for the red, type BC0700. Awesome. We already have this nice band here. Okay, it's about to get a little bit complicated with notes, so try to follow along. Okay, so we need to do a another set here, and that is gonna do the pan around here. Okay. All right, so we need to duplicate this. And for this node, we're gonna do 0.95 on this scale. And then 90 degrees on rotation. And then 0.8 on the location. Okay. I'm gonna take this gradient, duplicate it, and then duplicate it again. Set the second one to linear. Okay. Duplicate this mapping again, just because it has the least amount of settings that I need to change. And that is just going to be, this one is going to be reset to 1. And this one is going to be, let's just, right here. Boom. And then the C is going to be 0.2. Okay. Connect this one here, that one there. And let's take another one of our separate nodes. Shift D. And this time connecting it with the Z axis. Okay, let's duplicate this ramp, bring it down. And let's make the, let's desaturate it. Let's make it pure white. Perfect. Same ramp, duplicate it. Connect it here. And this one is going to be this one is going to be 0.302 and exchange the colors actually. So 0.302. Okay. Take your mix RGB, duplicate it, bring it here. Change the mix to lighten. And let's mix these two colors with a factor to 1. Okay, perfect. And what this does, I think we can see it already here. Okay, look at that. So it's already, we did a nice line through here. So we can, if you press Control Shift click, it's going to preview the section where it's taking effect. And this one, that one. So we're missing, we're mixing this arc here and the line that goes around it together. Awesome. Now we need to put all of that together. So another lighten. Gonna move this here. And let's do a math node. Set it to multiply add. Connect it here, connect it here, and we just want to get those values out and connect it here. Okay, perfect. You can see the effects already here. Awesome. And this, which is highlighting in white what it's selecting, we're going to actually take it and take it to the metal. I believe that's a song, right? Take it to the metal? No? Oh. Anyways, here, we're gonna move this to the side and duplicate it. And let's connect this one to the first one. All right. And then the factor, gonna connect this here and this here. Okay, so if you shift and right click and drag, you can create the segment, press G and you can move it. All right, so we have this node right here is connecting to the factor and the color. Here, perfect. And then we're gonna connect this one to the color and boom, there you have it. So we have here this node here that is affecting the metalness here, here and here. All right, perfect. Awesome. So we're pretty much almost halfway done. Alright, now we need to copy this one twice, the invert. And connect one of them to the multiply. duplicate one of the lightens and turn it into multiply. You might think, why didn't I use the math node? This one is looking into the colors when the colors and color values, and the math node is looking into values. Sorry, this one goes over here. And it's turning a bit of a mess, so let me see if I can. Okay. Leave that out. I know there's a shortcut to organize them, so let me see. Control plus no. I forgot what's the control to line them up, but it's okay for now. Let's move this one down. Okay. All right, so we have this one's connected. Now we need to do a ramp. Connected to our multiply. Let's make it linear. Turn it white. And then turn this one into a light gray. Around there. You can just move it a bit. We don't need to be specific with these ones. Can connect this to the roughness. I think that works. Then, so we get this nice metal shininess. Actually, let me make it a bit more white. Should be like actually darker. There we go. And this one a little bit of white just to give it a little bit of shine. Perfect. Let's do a pump. And the pump, we need to connect it to our multiply. Control shift right click. Smooth this here. And let's do it again. Okay. Just reorganizing this so you guys can have a better understanding of what is happening. Yeah, it's like a spider web. But anyways, This one is controlling the band right here. This one is controlling the outline right here. Then what I did is I selected these outlines here and there so we can get the metalness in there. And then I separated again so we can determine the roughness everywhere besides the inside of the band and here. So we get the nice metal here and here. Okay, excellent. That is that for that side. Let's go into the band. And we can do the same color, the same yellow. Oops, did I pick the bottom? Metal. Okay, perfect. We're gonna add the same color to the button. Perfect. And now we just have to do the bottom. And to the bottom, I'm actually gonna take this segment here. Let's copy it. Okay, cool. I was just testing to see if it was working. Perfect. All right, but we need to do some changes to it. So this stays the same. That stays the same. I'm just double checking on the side here. That stays the same. Okay. Here is where we invert. At 0, 101, and then for the top, I believe we can do the same. Yes. So it's already working. Get both of our lighten. Doing an invert. Duplicate this gradient. Let's take this to the metal. So we already have this nice metalness in the edge too, which is what we wanted. And to get the same kind of tone here. Let's go back to the top and just steal this ramp. Is that too much? Okay. Okay. Can you do this without this invert node? Yes. I just didn't want to mess around too much with inverting this and whatnot. Plus, it gave me some flexibility. All right. Yeah, I think that's it. Actually, instead of pure black, I think, yeah, I did like a gray. So I'm just gonna do a gray real quick, and that is it. As of right now, it's pretty done. I just don't like it completely black. And we can go here and just change this color. Just make it a dark gray. It's a small change, but later on with lighting, it'll make sense. So, let's go to the top. All right, and where do we find the black here? We find it here. All right, guys, so there you have it. The luxury Pokeball. Thank you for watching, and I should get back on creating more and more tutorials. Please like and subscribe. Any support helps out. I am gonna do them more energetically. My tutorials, it's just I do them really late and I don't want to wake up anybody here in the house, but definitely we are I'm looking at the feedback. Thank you guys for your support. The first Pokeball tutorial is almost at 2,000 views. That is amazing. Thank you guys for your support again, for all the likes and comments. Thank you and have a good one. Bye.